Like many students in Year 10, I studied Romeo and Juliet. Then in Year 12, I studied Hamlet. But when it came to analysis of the text, I got it wrong. My conclusions were incorrect, and so I was never confident in my understanding of Shakespeare. What compounded the problem was my speech impediment, which made reading, comprehension, and speaking difficult. Luckily, it was diagnosed when I was 4, which led to work with a speech pathologist to arrest my stutter. Following a Bachelor of Arts at Notre Dame University, Sydney, at 23, I went to London. I wanted classical training in acting. One day, 2 months after I had begun at the Royal Central School of Speech and Drama, I went to Shakespeare's Globe Theatre, on the south bank of the Thames. For $5, I saw Stephen Fry and Mark Rylance in Twelfth Night. I watched from the floor, in the groundlings section. I was meters away from these fantastic actors. They made the audience hear every word they said. They also enabled me to understand Shakespeare effortless. It was an eye-opener as to how well Shakespeare could be done. From that moment, I wanted to perform Shakespeare, and to do it well. My first Shakespeare play was in 2014, where I played the ghost of Hamlet's father for the ASC Random Theatre Company, at Finsbury Park, London. The season was 4 weeks, so when it ended, I toured Britain in productions of The Jungle Book and Sherlock Holmes. I did some commercials as well. For 18 months, between gigs, I taught in a pupil referral unit in West London, which is for kids who have been expelled from schools and can't have conventional schooling. I have scraped together an existence via everything other than Shakespeare's words. Life as a Shakespearean actor is tenuous. There is not a lot of work out there, even less in Australia. 2 years after my return to Sydney in 2015, I had to go to New Zealand, where I joined the pop-up Globe, to play Shakespeare. While at university, I was fortunate to get good financial advice from my parents. They are both teachers and advised me to have a satellite career, which would mean I never went hungry between roles. I am a trained drama and history teacher, and fill in for teachers at a high school in Lakemba. Several students think their teacher, Mr. Turner, is a weird person, as he speaks to himself on playground duty. When I was preparing to play Henry V, I would deconstruct a soliloquy, and walk around reciting it. I also practiced speeches. It took me 2 months to get the lines into my head. I am pretty strenuous with budgeting. I have to be ruthless when it comes to financial allocations, like my car repayments and hex debt. I need to put money aside, because after the Melbourne season of the pop-up Globe ends January the 28th, I will be an unemployed Shakespearean actor again. In June, after completing the Auckland season of Henry V and As You Like It, in which I play Le Beau, I flew to Britain. I went to Westminster Abbey specifically to pay homage to the real Henry V. I stood in front of his tomb, and quoted a couple of stanzas to myself. It was such a great experience.